Book of Tov, good morning. The Gemara says, Birkat Hashem hita ashir. The blessing Hashem makes you rich. So now, I can give you a segula to be rich. Who doesn't want to be rich? Raise your hand. Nobody.
We don't want to be rich, we want to be happy, that's all.
If you get rich, they're not going
to
sleep.
Everybody have to, why you didn't raise your hand?
Anyway,
the Pasuk says the Segula to be rich is written in the Torah. Birkat Hashem, the blessing of Hashem is making rich. What is blessing of Hashem? How we do the blessing of Hashem? So you know, only one blessing comes from Hashem. Because all the blessing we say is come from Chachamim. But only one blessing is written in the Torah clearly. Ve'achalta ve'savata ve'berachta. When you eat and you make the bracha, ve'berachta, you need to bless. But being the only blessing in the Torah, all the Torah obligation to make bracha is only Birkat HaMazon. So this is the hint of the Pasuk, that the Pasuk says, Birkat Hashem. The blessing of Hashem be kruid. That meaning to make Birkat HaMazon clearly good, it's gula to be ashir, to be rich. What meaning Birkat HaMazon? Everybody do Birkat HaMazon. I hope also. So the meaning we have to say it clearly, nicely, better to read, know by heart. If somebody knows Birkat HaMazon by heart, he has a problem, because he has the Yetzirah to say by heart. Better not to know by heart, and you have Birkat HaMazon, reading from the Sidur or the there are a lot of places that Birkat HaMazon is written there, in the form anyway, but read from the text and make it clearly, nice, every day. So this is Segula, and people that do it like that, meaning no running, say word by word, of course they will be rich and there is a blessing, promise, that they never, never, never in their life have problem with food, but parnasa, never. But this condition that to make the Birkat HaMazon nicely and clear. Like everybody know, we feed the meal, make Birkat HaMazon. Start yesterday, Birkat HaMazon. If somebody eats alone, of course they make Birkat HaMazon alone. Because three people eating bread, they make zimun. It's also if two people eat bread and the third one eat mezonos or eat fruit, you can make the zimun. But who makes the zimun? The guy that makes the bread. Better that three people eat bread, but there's no way. So even if there is a two people eat bread and the other one eat mezonot or something, fruit or something like that, you consider like zimun. So after the zimun, we may Birkat HaMazon. We need to know Birkat HaMazon. We need to be thinking about constantly Birkat HaMazon. Like we said yesterday, better to do it from the Sidur. And you do the Birkat HaMazon, don't do some people make mistake. You think Birkat HaMazon only in Shabbat. Some people think Birkat HaMazon is time to set the table. So maybe Birkat HaMazon is time to move plate, to move that. No, Birkat HaMazon is important like 18. Even it's more than that, because 18 it's the Rabbanan. Birkat HaMazon the Oraita. And the same 18, we don't move, don't see, don't look at the form, not if somebody had a form ring, don't touch it. Send to Birkat HaMazon, we need to be constantly in the Birkat HaMazon to make it good. We need 7 people at least eat bread, and the other people eat something else. That meaning, if there are 10 people eat bread, either 7 eat bread, 7 eat bread, and 3 of them eat, let's say they eat fruits, or vegetables even, or mezonot, of course, you can make zimun. But if all 6 people only eat bread, we can't make zimun in 10, when we end up 10 people, make the name of Hashem, Elokeinu. But less than 10, we don't make the name of Hashem. So even though in Minyan, if there is 6 people, and 4 people, let's say there is 10 people, 6 of them didn't daven, and 4 of them daven, 6 of them didn't daven, 4 of them daven already, we can make a Minyan. But in Zimun, it needs more. We need 7 people. 7 people eat bread, and afterwards, if the top 3 people eat other things, like fruits, even the drink orange juice or milk, but they drink amount of revit, meaning they drink one shot of cup of milk, one shot of cup of orange juice. So they got 3 people, so they're allowed to make zimun of 10 because they consider that they ate something. But they drink water, it doesn't help. They drink the orange juice little bit, it doesn't help. Better to eat mezonot of fruit, so they make zimun and asara. As we know, we make three people make zimun. Let's say two people want to go and one want to leave, it didn't finish. So it's no problem, they can make zimun. And the people that want to make, they make the blessing. The other guy waiting for them, they say, they start the zimun, they answer the zimun, and continue eating. After he finish eating, he make the Birkat HaMazon. He doesn't require to make right away the Birkat HaMazon with them. Only answer them, the Baruch Shachar Mishalom. According to Ben Ishcha, it's better that they wait for them to Azan at HaKol. But it's machloket. You don't want, you want to create quick, right away. But the purpose is to live, to answer the Zimun. Same thing with 10 people. There are 10 people eating. Same thing, you can make the Zimun. And the people that want to bench, they make the bracha. And the other people continue eating till they finish eating. They doesn't require to make another Zimun. Because they have the Zimun with the 10 people. Afterward, they finish eating, they make the Birkat HaMazon regular. There is 3 people sitting and eating. And one of them want to go. So even though he want to go, he need to wait for them to make the zimun. He's not allowed to go. But they can ask a favor, they can make a zimun, and he will make the zimun and go, and they will stay, finish eating. What's going to be if somebody didn't realize, didn't pay attention, there was 3 people eating bread, one of them make zimun, make Birkat HaMazon without the zimun. Immediately the zimun, they say, well, why are you doing it like that? We want to make zimun. So I didn't pay attention. So what are we going to do now? Even if he finished Birkat HaMazon, they allowed to make the Zimun with him. He doesn't make the Zimun, he only answered the Zimun. And the reward of the Zimun, they haven't got. Only they helped him to make the Zimun. So the Chidush is that even though he made the Birkat HaMazon already, because he ate with them and we had to trip him together, they allowed to make the Zimun now, after he made the Birkat HaMazon, he answered Baruch Shachar Mishalom, and go home. And anyway, the mitzvah for me, we lost the mitzvah of the Zimun, but they have the reward of the mitzvah. This is the way to correct this problem. Bezat Hashem, as we say, we make Zimun. If somebody going to wedding or some occasion and you need to go home before the people make the Zimun, because the halakha is you obligate to answer the Zimun. If you could make Zimun by 10 people, the best thing. This is the best thing. Usually in a wedding, they can do it. But if you do it, if you can do the best in this way, so the halacha says that before you're washing the hand, make condition in yourself that you don't gather with that people. Say at night, say condition, I'm eating now, but I don't involve with these people to make zimun with them. In this case, you're allowed to go without zimun, but even though, better to do it with 3. Usually to find 3 people, it's not so hard. It's easy to find 3 people. So in this case, you need to go early, so you do it this way. You do condition before eating, and afterwards, make zimun and 3 and go home. We spoken about zimun, so we said that 3 people eat bread, make zimun, you need 2. But what's going to be if someone is killed under bar mitzvah? So the Rechai says, according to Sephardi custom, you can gather him like a zimun. It means 2 people, old people eat bread. And that small boy ate bread also, but he wasn't 13 years old. So you can make zimun with him. The Ashkenazi don't hold it, but the Sephardi. What age you can take him for zimun? So there is 2 opinions. Some say, the Ben Ishchai say, 9.
Wow.
From 9 and on, you can make him for zimun. Some say even 6, but we don't take 9. So then you can take it for zimun to make zimun for 3 people. But if you say the Birkat HaMazon properly, and the child says the Birkat HaMazon is proper, you can make that child for zimun. But this is for 3. What is going to be with the reason 9 people and the was a child? So some poskim say the bar mitzvah. Some say if you're older than 9, you can eat it even for 10 people. So, but of course, when they eat the bread. But regular surdai, there is 7 people eat bread and there are 3 people eat vegetables or something like that, you can make the zimun in the name of Hashem. As we say, we're speaking about the mitzvah of zimun, that is very important to do. If we say that if somebody eats with 3 people and one of them want to go, so 2 of them want to go, so they can make the zimun, and the other guy can continue eating, and when he finish eating, he make the Birkat HaMazon. So the question coming, when he answers the Zimun, of course, he doesn't allow to eat. He need to answer the Zimun. But what's going to be if he want to continue eating? When he allowed to eat? So there is two parts. The first part to say the answer, the Baruch Shachanu Mishalot Uvachayinu. This is the main thing you need to stop. But the Rama said that you need to wait till the make the Birkat HaMazon, said the Birkat HaZal et HaKol. So you don't allow to eat till the Chazal, till the guy that make the Zimun say HaZal et HaKol, then he answer Amen. Afterwards, he could continue eating. This is the Rama. The Maran, HaShulchan Aruch says, no, you don't allow to wait till then. You can allow only to answer Baruch Shachan. The Ben Ish Chai Ed, that he recommended to do like the Rama. So according to the Ben Ish Chai, we need to wait to HaZal et HaKol, but according to HaShulchan Aruch, we don't know. The Ben Ish Chai said, like do the Rama. But if there is 10 people, and you answer the Zimun, according to all the opinions, together, they agreed that he doesn't need to wait more than the other Baruch Shachan Mishalom. If there is, let's say, 10 people, you say, okay, no? You answer the Baruch Shachan Mishalom, according to all the Shittot, you're allowed to continue eating. When you finish, you know, of course, you need to make the Birkat HaMazon yourself. I want to repeat again what the Pope, about Zimun. The Ben Ish Chai said, Tzer Mod Yisrael Achar Zimun. It's very important to look for Zimun. כי דבר גדול הוא הפיקטים לסלק על ידי סטרח או לפותח. In the name of the Arizal, he says that this סטרח are coming and things about art and this is what is moon to take away. כשם שמצווה לחזור אחר תושה להגיד מצווה to look for three people, עוד יותר מצווה ויותר to look for ten people. To praise הקדוש ברוך הוא. And because of that, we say, in the name of the Bracha of Hashem, this is the Zimun. So as we speak in the few weeks about the Zimun, so this is the problem of Zimun, to make Zimun, to take three people, the best thing they eat bread, if you don't eat bread, at least two eat bread, and the other thing and other things, make Zimun. We make 10 people, we repeat again, it need to be 7 people that eat bread, and the other 3 people eat something else, so can make Zimun in 10. We Bezrat Hashem speaking about the Zimun, what they're going to be if somebody didn't eat, and they made Zimun and they didn't eat nothing. So what do you need to say? He couldn't say, Baruch Shachanu Mishalom, Achanu mean eating. He didn't eat. But on the other hand, people make praise Hashem, thanks Hashem. He couldn't sit silence. He need to say something. So the Shulchan Aruch says, there is a simple thing to say. You need to say the following sentence. Baruch Hu Borach Shmo Tamid Leolam Vayed. This is not easy to remember, you need to write it down. Baruch Hu Borach Shmo Tamid Leolam Vayed. The initial is Boshet Lo. Baruch Hu Borach Shmo Tamid Leolam Vayed. Then you praise Hashem forever. Baruch Hu Borach Shmo Tamid Leolam Vayed. This name of Hashem will be forever. Praise. Say Baruch Hu Borach Shmo Leolam Vayed. If somebody, let's say, eat different place, let's say eat in the car, he finish it, make bracha achrona, he come in, right? Suddenly he make zimun. So now he recently ate, a minute ago he finished eating. But he didn't eat with them, he ate in a different place. In this case, the same thing, he couldn't answer Baruch Shachanu, even though he ate. But he didn't eat with them, he ate alone, a different place. In this case also we say, Baruch Hu Borach Shmo, תמיד לעולם ועד. בעזרת השם, don't forget, tonight, ראש חודש, אדר, 2 days, נכנס אדר, מרבים בשמחה. בעזרת השם, יתברך, we're speaking about ברכת המזון. ברכת המזון, there is a 4 blessing, and this blessing, the בן איש חי, the הלכה says it like 18. We don't allow to answer nothing, to speak between that, from the beginning till the end, this like 18. So if somebody heard Kaddish, to shout, he don't allow to answer. Same thing, you don't have to some people set the table between Shmona and Birkat HaMazon or do things. No, it's not allowed. Birkat HaMazon, like Shmona, you don't have to sit. Shmona is standing, Birkat HaMazon is sitting. But the other hand, the other halachot of Shmona is there. Sit in the table and concentrate with the bracha. From A to Z, all the bracha need to make that time, not to make a thing hinting with the head, if somebody calls you, you want to come. You say, hey, yes, one minute. You don't allow to do it. ברכת המזון, same thing in 18. We need to concentrate it with the ברכה of ברכת המזון. And this is will give us, there is a big, big סגולה in ברכת המזון. If you see it carefully, the book says that if somebody made ברכת המזון as right to do, he has סגולה that he never, never, never have problem with פרנסה in his life. Never. All his life we have, ברוך השם, we have a good, good, good living. As we say, Seder, Birkat HaMazon is one of the important things in the mitzvah. The only mitzvah that Torah is written clearly, Ve'achalta ve'savata ve'rachta. You need to bless Hashem. There is one thing that we do, B'nei Nishchai, during the Shulchan Aruch, we don't put knife in the table during the Birkat HaMazon. There is a reason, the Gemara says, the simple reason, one man was davening Birkat HaMazon, and there was a knife on the table. You don't believe the story. He came to the Birkat HaMazon. We have this blessing of Bonei Yerushalayim. He built Yerushalayim. And he was so, so upset that the building didn't build. So he damaged himself with the knife. Because of that, we don't put knife on the table. This is the Gemara giving. The Ben Shai says that there is another code of the Kabbalah. It's also not to put. So, it's... Because the Pshat, it's only in the weekday, not in Shabbat. But because it's the Ben Ish Chai, even in Shabbat, take it out the knives on the table before we make Birkat HaMazon. If you don't have a way to pack it, please cover it. Put something on it that will not be revealed. Some poskim says that if somebody thirsty, if he need bread, enough bread is thirsty, so he doesn't know to say Birkat HaMazon yet, he need to drink something. Because the observer, the food, is coming by the drinking. Because of that, we need to think about that. Don't drink before we drink, eating, you make the Birkat HaMazon. You haven't got water, so you need to make Birkat HaMazon anyway. But better to find a drink or something, water or wine or something to drink. Somebody ate bread. You don't remember. If you make Birkat HaMazon, it could be, Birkat HaMazon, it's not so rare, but it's not happened, but sometimes he had mezonot, or asher yatzar, after bathroom, he don't remember, he make Birkat HaMazon, he make ma'al ha'michya, didn't make, he make asher yatzar, didn't make, he doesn't know. He's so busy, he has busy, busy with the business, he don't remember if you he made it or not. What the halacha says, if you have doubt, you make or not make, you don't make. Safek brachot la'akel, meaning, if you doubt, if you do it or not do it, so we have doubt, so don't do it the bracha. Because of that, you need to remember that you do it. If this case happened, if you could eat another kazayit, mezonot, it's better that you should make bracha. With the asher yatzar, you need to find somebody that's going to make asher yatzar, I've come enough for you. But you couldn't make the asher yatzar only bracha, or nefashot, after drinking or eating, if you're not sure that you need to make bracha. Because the halacha safek brachot la'akel. If you have doubt, you don't make the bracha. When there is a holiday, we're adding in Birkat HaMazon the adding of the holiday. Shabbat, we say Retzeva Chalitzenu, Chol Moed, we say Yerush Chol Yalev Yavor, the holiday. What's going to be in Shabbat, Sabbath, you didn't make, you miss it. You forgot to say Retzeva Chalitzenu. There is a 3 meals in Shabbat, night, morning, and Sudat Nishit. In the night and morning, you're obligated to eat bread. Without bread, you don't, you don't say Sudat Shabbat. You eat mezonot, any mezonot doesn't help. You need to eat bread. Because of that, if you eat bread, you need Birkat HaMazon. So because of that, if somebody forget to say Retzeva Lechalitzenu, you need to repeat the Birkat HaMazon all over. So if somebody finished Birkat HaMazon and didn't say Retzeva Lechalitzenu, you need to go back for the beginning to start again. But if you remember, in medium of Birkat HaMazon, let's say, we say, after Retzeva Lechem, Baruch Atah Hashem, Bonei Yerushalayim. And afterward, he said, the first fourth bracha, Melech HaTov HaMetiv. So if you remember, after he said, Baruch Atah Hashem, Bonei Yerushalayim, and didn't start the next bracha, so there is in the Sidurim, you can look, there is a special bracha to say, Baruch Atah Hashem, Natan Shabbatot Limnucha, Lamoz Lotum Rit, Baruch Atah Hashem, Mekadesh Shabbat. This, you read the Sidurim, you see it, So this adding, you say, you did seret seva chalitzeno, and you start, borel baruch atah Hashem bonei Yerushalayim. So you need to say this bracha and continue. If you start, baruch atah Hashem, and you say baruch atah Hashem for start a Torah mitiv, you can change to this bracha, שנתן שבתות, אבל if you start a Torah mitiv, so in this case you need to go back to the beginning. This הלכה required in the night, in the שחרית, in the morning. But the last issue, because there's opinion that you can eat the Sudash Tishit Mizanot, or food, something else, so don't obligate to eat daf and bread. Very recommend to eat bread. But if somebody eat Mizanot, Yotze, so in this case, in Sudash Tishit, you forget Yotze Vachalitzenu, you don't need to repeat, you continue to eat the beginning end. Say, you need to correct yourself, and Sudash Tishit, no. We are adding also Rosh Chodesh, Yaleh V'Yavor, Chanukah, Purim Al HaNisim. This thing is not obligated to eat bread. Because of that, if somebody forget to say Al HaNisim in Chanukah, Purim, or say Yaleh V'Yavor in Rosh Chodesh, he doesn't need to go back. If he say, Bonei Yerushalayim, there is Sat Bracha without the name of Hashem, שנתן שבתות לראשי חודשים לזיכרון, לא to greet, that's all. But if he continue, he don't need to repeat and not correct himself. But in holidays, let's say Pesach, Shavuot, Sukkot, our custom is also not to repeat, but only the first night of Sukkot, the first night of Pesach, because we obligate to eat bread or eat matzah, so in this case, if we didn't say Yaleh V'Yavor, we need to repeat all over to the beginning like Shabbat. But in the other days of the holidays, because you don't require to eat lechem, bread, so in this case you don't need to repeat. So again, Tzeva Chalitzenu in the night and the morning, and Yaleh V'Yavor in the Pesach and Sukkot in the first night, this is the only place that you need to repeat all over the Birkat HaMazon.